In the last class, I have explained, we revised the first unit. In the first unit, see the questions. Define linear and non-linear elements. What are the linear elements and non-linear elements? Anyone? What do you mean by linear and non-linear elements? Okay, see here. See on the screen. Linear elements means which obey Ohm's law. You have to write this definition. Linear elements means which obeys Ohm's law. Examples are resistor, capacitor, and inductor. That is, it is having a characteristics containing a straight line passing through origin with a definite slope. So linear elements means the power is 1. V is equal to IR. What is the power of V? V power 1 is equal to I power 1, R power 1. Okay, power is 1. These are called linear elements. Suppose P is equal to I square R. I square is linear or non-linear? Anyone? What is I square, linear or non-linear? Power is 2, it is non-linear. If power is 1, I square means the power is 2. That is non-linear element. Linear element, power is 1. Okay, those are called linear elements. If power is 2, 3, 4, 5, if power is 2 and more than 2, those are non-linear elements. Okay, so in exam, write this definition, what is visible on the screen. Linear elements are those which obey Ohm's law, for example, resistor, inductor, and capacitor. Now see non-linear elements. Non-linear elements are those which does not obey Ohm's law, for example, diode, transistor, etc. If you write this much, they'll give 2 marks in the exam. And examples. Definition and examples. That is about linear and non-linear elements. Any doubt in non-linear and non-linear elements?
No, sir.
Okay. Next question is, see, what is complex power? This also has studied in the first unit. Complex power means, see here. See, complex power. S is equal to V into I star. S is equal to V into I star. For I, I am taking, first of all, theta is the angle in between voltage and current. S is the total power or complex power. Or S is also called as apparent power. S is called apparent power. Theta is the power factor angle. Theta is the angle in between voltage and current. In between V and I, we are having some angle that is called theta. So here, if you move in the clockwise direction, angle is negative. If you move in the anti-clockwise direction, it will be positive. But I see here current is lagging the voltage. We are moving in the clockwise direction. That's why I'm taking negative angle. Now see here, S is equal to V into I star. Here V is on the x-axis, 0 axis. So here, let us take V at an angle zero. Voltage is at an angle 0 because it is on the x-axis. Now for current, it is angle theta. Therefore, V is equal to V into cos 0 plus j. Cos 0 is 1, sin 0 is 0. V into 1, there is V. Into I cos theta plus j sin theta. Multiply with V, with this one, we will get S is equal to VA cos theta plus j VA sin theta. And VA cos theta is P, you already know this. And VA sin theta is Q. Therefore, total power S is equal to P plus JQ. This much you write in the exam for 2 marks about complex power. They will give 2 marks. This is the solution for the second question. Next, see. These are the 2 questions which are in the first unit. And one more problem is there. This is in the third unit. Later will come. What is equivalent resistance of single phase merits and demerits of slipping, fourth unit. MCB is fifth unit. Now see F, question number F. 5 2-volt cells, each having an internal resistance of 0.2, are connected in series to a load resistance of 14 ohms. Find the current flowing in the circuit. Can anyone tell the answer for this? Connect 5 2-volt cells in series. In series, voltage will be added or same? In series lo current same untunda, voltage same untunda? Anyone? In series, current will be same. So 5 2-volt cells are in series. 5 × 2. What is the total voltage? 2 + 2 + 2 + 2. Voltage will be added in series. What is the total voltage? 5 2-volt cells means 5 × 2. Hello. What is the total voltage? 5 cells series means 10 volts. Is it 10 volts?
Yes, sir.
Now 0.2 ohms. 5 cells are having each 0.2 ohm. If you add 0.2 5 times, how much you will get? 0.2 ni 5 times add just say emotion, what you will get?
1.
So this 1 ohm is in series with 14 ohms. 1 plus 14, how much? 15 ohms. Okay, 15 ohms. Now voltage is 10 volts. Resistance is 15 ohm. What is the current? Write down current I is equal to V by R. V is 10. Resistance is 15. 10 by 15. What is the value? I is equal to V by R, right? I is equal to V by R. V is 10. 5 × 2, 10 volts. Resistance is 14 plus 1, 15. 10 by 15. How much?
0.66
ampere. This is the solution for this F bit. This is also first unit. Next, these three questions are related to the first unit. A, B, and F are first unit. Okay. Now see the long answers in the first unit. Explain different types of sources. What are the different types of sources? Anyone? There are dependent sources and independent sources. But in your syllabus, you are having only independent sources. But theory you can write. Sources are two types, dependent and independent. Independent and dependent. What are the independent sources? Two sources are there, independent. What are those? Independent voltage and independent current source. Independent sources are which does not depend on anything. They themselves generate the power. That is nothing but independent source. Dependent source means directly they can't generate. They'll depend on some other source. That is called dependent source. See. 1 minute, I am showing. See here, independent source definition. Independent sources are the sources whose output does not depend upon the circuit parameters like voltage and current. Okay. Here, independent and dependent sources. What is the symbol for the independent sources? Independent voltage source. I will write it on the board. 1 minute. This is an independent voltage source. This is an independent voltage source symbol. This is an independent current source symbol. This is an independent current source symbol. Okay. This is the dependent voltage source symbol. Diamond shape will take. For dependent sources, the symbol is taken as diamond shape. This is the dependent current source. I means current source. Arrow is upward means current is flowing in the upward direction. Okay. Independent voltage source is represented with plus and minus and with a diamond symbol. And dependent voltage source and dependent current source is diamond symbol with arrow. This is the dependent current source. Independent sources we can represent like this. Independent voltage source. So with circle we are representing for independent voltage sources. Independent voltage source, independent current source. If we use diamond symbol, these are the dependent sources. So independent voltage source are independent voltage and current source. Dependent sources, how many types? Anyone? Dependent sources, how many types? Anyone know? First one is voltage dependent voltage source. First one is voltage dependent voltage source, first dependent source. Second one is voltage dependent current source. Voltage dependent current source. Third one is current dependent current source. Current dependent current source. Last one is current dependent voltage source. Current dependent voltage source. Okay, these are the four dependent sources. These are the four dependent sources. Any doubt in the independent and dependent sources, different types of sources? They are asking for 5 marks, but in your syllabus there is no dependent source. See, in the next question they are asking the problem by using dependent source. See, diamond symbol they are using and they are putting an arrow. Okay, this type of problem they won't, even if they give, they will give the marks because it is not in your syllabus. Dependent sources are not there in your syllabus. So first question you write dependent and independent. Second question, power absorbed by each component in the circuit. They are asking by using dependent source. Generally, they won't ask. Even if they ask, they will give marks. Now, see the second question. State and explain Thevenin's theorem. Yesterday in the previous class, we had discussed the Thevenin's theorem. Have you discussed or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, see, you know the statement and explain Thevenin's theorem. They are asking for 5 marks. Now they are giving one problem to determine the Thevenin voltage. Determine V, Thevenin voltage, using Thevenin's theorem. Here they are asking. So remove this source, 5 ampere. Remove this current source and determine VTH. You know how to determine VTH. Okay. This is the second question. Thevenin's theorem, you see the problems. Already in your notes, there are some problems. You go through those. Madam had explained, I think. You go through those problems, Thevenin's theorem. These are the questions in the first unit. Okay. First unit, second and third questions are related to the first unit. In the 2 marks question, they are asking A bit, B bit, and F bit. 3 questions in the first unit. Now I'll go to the second unit. See the second unit. 1 second. Now see here, in second unit what they are asking. 4th and 5th question are related to the second unit. 4th question and 5th question are second unit. First I will see the 5th question, you see, then we will go for the 4th question. Derive the expression for RMS value of alternating current. I is equal to I. Sin omega t. They are giving the instantaneous current. RMS value of the current he is asking. Derivation, you know, for this RMS value. Do you know the derivation? For 5 marks, they are asking. RMS value of alternating current. Do you know the derivation or not? RMS value derivation for AC current. If you don't know, I will derive on the board. If you know, no problem. Do you want me to derive?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I will derive on the board. See here. See here, they are giving I is equal to I m sin omega. This is the instantaneous value. And average value is equal to 1 by total time period of 1 cycle. 1 cycle time period is 2 pi integral of 0 to pi. See here, this is an instantaneous current, input current. See on the board graphs. First graph is input current. Second graph is output current, I naught. Second graph is I naught, output current. What do you mean by rectifier? What do you mean by rectifier? Which converts AC to DC? Diode is the rectifier, I think. Rectifier means which converts AC to DC. See, in the first graph we are having positive and negative, that is AC. In the second graph we are having only DC plus. We are having only plus, only one polarity, positive polarity, that is DC. So we are converting AC to DC. First graph is AC, second graph is the DC. Now I will take the average and RMS value. In the problem they are asking only RMS value, but I want to explain the average value also. Sometimes they ask the average value also in the exam. See here, if you take the limits 0 to pi and 1 by 2 pi, 1 by 2, V naught is E, not V average, the current average. Average current is equal to 1 by total time period. Total time period of one cycle is 2 pi, 1 by 2 pi. Integral of 0 to pi, I am taking the limits 0 to pi. So two cycles, within a one cycle, we are having two symmetric cycles, multiply with 2. Two symmetric cycles are there. Two symmetric, multiply with 2. One cycle, two cycles. In a period of 2 pi, two symmetric cycles. 2 into 0 to pi. 2 into 0 to pi. What is the instantaneous value? Im sin omega t d omega t. This is the average value. Now see the RMS value. IRMS square is equal to 1 by 2 pi integral of 0 to pi Im sin omega t d omega t. Im sin omega t d omega t square. See, in the average value formula and RMS value formula, what is the difference you have observed? What is the difference? Difference same observation, sir.
Only one cycle is taken, the RM.
Okay, 1 by 2 pi we had taken here. And limits are 0 to 2 pi. See, in RMS value I had taken 0 to 2 pi. I am not multiplying with 2. But here when you take 0 to pi, I am taking multiply with 2. Why in the first equation I am taking 2 into 2 times integral of 0 to pi? Suppose if I take in the first equation 0 to 2 pi, average will be 0. Why average is 0? Means if you add plus and minus, it will be 0. But here we are in the in this graph, we are not adding plus and minus. We are adding plus and plus 2 times. That's why I am multiplying with 2. But in this case, it is no problem. Here we are taking square. See here, in average value in the first equation, I average, I am, there is power is 1. Power is 1. See left hand side and right hand side. Instantaneous value power is 1. Im sin omega t is power 1. But in the second equation, I am taking square. Here I am taking square. Here also I am taking square. If you take square, the average will not come to 0. That's why I am taking the limits 0 to 2 pi here. But here I am taking 0 to pi. Now see here. In the problem, he is asking RMS value. RMS means root mean square. If you bring square to this side, it becomes square root. If you bring square to the right hand side, it becomes square root. 1 by square root of root mean square. This is mean square. See, we are taking the mean of this square. Mean means 1 by 2 pi. Square we are taking for the root mean square. RMS means root mean square. Now, for the in the problem, they are asking only RMS value. See, RMS value will be
that is 1 by 2 pi integral of 0 to 2 pi. Im is constant, take outside the integral. Im is constant, take outside the integral. What is sine square omega t?
Convert it to summation term. Sine square omega t is equal to?
This is Im square. Sine square omega t.
I am taking Im square outside the integral. What is sine square omega t? Because for square we can't apply the integration. For sine square omega t we can't apply the integration. That's why I'm converting sine square omega t into 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2. Now bring this to outside, that is Im square by 4 pi. I'm bringing to outside Im square by 4 pi. What is integral of 1 by 2? 1. Integral of 1 into d omega t. With respect to omega t, I am doing the integration. Integral of omega 1 into d omega t is omega t. What is the integral of cos 2 omega t? What is the integral of sine 2 cos 2 omega t? Sine 2 omega t by 2. Why are not getting divided by omega 2 omega? Because with respect to d omega t we are doing. If you do with respect to dt, we will get divided by 2 omega. But here with respect to d omega t we are doing the integration. That's why we won't get divided by 2 omega. We will get only divided by 2. Now substitute the limits
here. 2 pi and 0 substitute. That is Im square by 4 pi. 2 pi minus sine 2 pi is sine 4 pi is 0. 2 pi substitute here. Sine 4 pi is 0. Minus 0 minus sine 0 is 0. Sine 0 is 0. Finally, you will get 2 pi here. 2 pi minus 0. Upper limit is 2 pi minus 0, lower limit is 0. That is Im square by 4 pi into 2 pi.
This is your. Now bring the square to this side and tell me the value, final value. IRMS is equal to. Cancel those 2 pi and 4 square by 2. Bring square to that side. That is your RMS value. What is the value? This is your RMS value. IRMS is equal to Im by root. If you do this derivation, they will give 5 marks in the exam to you. If you are hanged out, you can ask me this. If they ask average value, we have to take this formula. We will get answer, you will get. This is the average value. RMS value is this one. Is it okay? In other integration, you can do that for average value. Now see the question. Derive the expression for RMS value of alternating current. So now we have derived the formula for RMS value for AC current. Alternating current means AC current. IRMS is equal to Im by root 2. Okay. Any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Okay. Next, we'll go for the next question, that is, derive the relation between phase and line voltage and current in balanced three-phase star connection. What is the relation between line and phase voltage in star connection? Three-phase star connection? I think it was derived to you. What is the value? చేసారా లేదా మీ నోట్స్ లో ఉందా లేదా రిలేషన్ బిట్వీన్ ద లైన్ వోల్టేజ్ సీ ది హియర్ రిలేషన్ బిట్వీన్ ఫేజ్ అండ్ లైన్ వోల్టేజ్ అండ్ కరెంట్ ఇన్ బ్యాలెన్స్డ్ త్రీ ఫేజ్ స్టార్ కనెక్షన్ No or not? Otherwise, I'll derive on the board. Hello? Tell me. Hello? Not audible what you are saying?
Explain it, sir.
Okay. I'll derive it on the board, you see. This is very important for 5 marks. One second. See the star connection. And this is the star connection. First of all, tell me, what is star is series or parallel connection? Star is the series or parallel connection. We have two types of connections, star and the one is delta. Star is series or parallel?
Series
connection. Okay. Star is the series connection. In series, current will be same. That's why I'll take line current is equal to phase current. In star connection, VL is equal to root 3 into V phase. So in the problem he is asking, in the question he is asking to derive the relation between VL and V phase. VL is equal to root 3 into V phase. We have to derive the relation in between line voltage and phase voltage. But line current is equal to phase current because in series current will be same. Now we'll derive the relation between line voltage and phase voltage. Now see here.
Here, this is the neutral. This is neutral. Voltage between phase and neutral is phase voltage. Voltage between two phases, R phase and Y phase, that is the line voltage.
Phase voltage means voltage in between line and neutral. One phase and neutral is the phase voltage. Line voltage means in between two phases, R and Y. Or R and B, or Y and B. If we take the voltage in between two phases, that is called line voltage. Now he is asking in the problem to determine the relation between the line voltage and phase voltage. First, I will draw the phase voltage. See here.
Let us take this phase one, this phase two, this phase three.
I am taking three phases. R phase is the phase one. Y phase is the. I am taking V1, V2, V3 are the phase voltages.
What is the angle in between V1 and V2?
What is the angle in between V1 and V2? degrees. Total 360 degrees.
We are having three phases. The angle in between V1 and V2 is 120. Angle in between V2 and V3 is 120. Angle in between
V3 and V1 is 120. Angle in between any two phases is 120 degrees.
Now I'll take the reflections of this. Minus V1. Minus V2. Minus V3. Now what is the angle in between
V1 and minus V3? V1 and minus V3. First of all, tell me what is minus V1, minus V2, minus V3? Negative phase voltages. Minus V1, minus V2, minus V3 are the negative phase voltages. V1, V2, V3 are positive phase voltages. What do you mean by positive and negative phase voltage? See here. If current flows from
phase to neutral,
then it is called positive phase voltage. Suppose if current flows from neutral to phase, that is negative phase voltage. Remember, if current flows from R phase to neutral, that is from phase to neutral, that is called positive phase voltage. If current flows from neutral to phase, that is called negative phase voltage. Now, what is the angle in between one positive and negative phase voltage?
If this is 120, what is this angle?
60.
How much? 60. Is it 60?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It is 60. Now see here, now V1 is one phase, minus V3 is another phase. So in between two phases, I will draw the line voltage now. See, in between V1 and minus 3 V3, I will draw the line voltage. Construct the parallelogram.
In between V1 and minus V3, V1 is one phase, minus V3 is another phase. In between these two phases, I will draw the line voltage. V1 is phase voltage, V3 is also a phase voltage, negative phase voltage. So I am constructing the parallelogram.
I will take the parallel line for this. These two are parallel lines.
For minus V3, I will take the parallel line from V1. For V1,
I will take the parallel line from minus V3. Okay. These two are parallel lines. These two are parallel lines. This is the parallelogram. These two are intersecting at one particular point.
V1, V3 lines are intersecting at one particular point. This point.
So this is the parallelogram. In parallelogram, diagonal is your line voltage.
In parallelogram, diagonal is your line voltage. Okay.
And this voltage I am calling it as V13.
See here, in between V1 and V3 I am drawing. First I am taking positive suffix.
This is positive suffix. 1 is positive suffix. 3 is negative suffix.
3 is the negative suffix. V13 is the line voltage. Now here,
then if it is 60 degrees, what is this angle?
What is the angle in between phase and line voltage?
Phase and line voltage. Angle is?
Is it 30 degrees? Is it 30 or not?
This is 120. In between V1 and V2, 120. V1 and minus V2 is 60. In between phase and line voltage is 30. Okay. Now I will derive the line voltage. VL is equal to, I want the length of this line. Drop a perpendicular.
Drop a perpendicular there.
I'm dropping the perpendicular line. Then this is one right angle triangle, this is another right angle triangle, this is right angle triangle, this is right angle triangle.
Four right angle triangles are there.
In this, this is the, suppose if I take, I want this value, I want this value. If you add these two values, that is your line voltage.
If you add those two values, this value and this value, that is your line voltage, VL.
First I will take this value. Take this right angle triangle. In this right angle triangle, hypotenuse is V1. Adjacent to theta is this value. Opposite to theta is this value. What is this value?
V1 cos theta. This is V1 cos theta. V1 sin theta.
The horizontal component is V1 cos 30 plus, take this right angle triangle. In this right angle, otherwise you take this right angle triangle, any triangle you take. Let us take this one. For getting this value, I am taking this. These two are parallel lines, V1. V1 adjacent side is this 30. V1 cos 30. That is 2 into V1 cos 30. 2 into cos 30 is root 3 by 2. VL is equal to V root 3 into V phase.
V1 is the phase voltage. Therefore, line voltage is equal to root 3 times of the phase voltage. This derivation you have to write in the exam for 5 marks. If they ask for 5 marks, we have to write these two relations. And derive this. We have to derive that. VL is equal to V1 is phase voltage. VL is equal to V13. VL is equal to root 3 into V phase. If you write this much in the exam, they will give 5 marks. Relation between line and phase voltage in star connection. Doubting them?
No, sir.
Somebody is asking something. What is that? Hello? No doubt? Okay. This is star connection. For delta connection, what are the formulas? For delta connection, in the problem they are not asking.
For delta connection, delta is the parallel connection. In parallel, voltage will be same. VL is equal to V phase. IL is equal to root 3 into I phase.
Derivation will be same. Here IL, I1 will get here. IL is equal to I1 cos 30 plus I1 cos 30. IL is equal to root 3 into I phase. Previously we have drawn the phasor diagram for voltage. Now draw the phasor diagram for currents, you will get the same thing. IL is equal to root 3 into I phase. In our question they are asking for star connection. So this is about star and delta. In the second unit. Okay. Okay, this is about the question number 5. Derive the relation between phase and line voltage and current in balanced three-phase star connection. They are asking only star connection. Okay, now come to the fourth question. Compute the average and average value of square root. He is asking average value. Sometimes he may ask RMS value also. So next question is this one. First we'll do this. Can anyone tell me how we'll calculate the average value for this problem? For this problem. Okay, I'll solve it on the board. We have to determine the average value. See here. In this, we are getting the output voltage from 0 to 0.1. Half period is 0.1 to 0.3. Similarly, next 0.3 to 0.4 on period, 0.4 to 0.6 it is the half period. Now here, total time period is equal to on period plus on time plus off time. Now here from 0 to 0.1 we are getting the output voltage. What is the output voltage? 0 to 0.1 we are getting how much? What is the voltage? 20 volts. See, at 0 the value is 20. At 0.01 value is 20. At 0.05 value is 20. At 0.1 is 20. Therefore, your limits are 0 to 0.1. What is your total time period? Your total time period is, what is the value? One cycle. One cycle is T. One cycle is equal to on plus off. Total period is 0.3 seconds. Now see here, average value is asked. Average value is equal to 1 by total time period. 1 by total time period. Integral of 0 to on period. Instantaneous value See the formula for average value. In the derivation also I had told. Average value is equal to 1 by total time period.
Average value is equal to 1 by 0.3. 1 by
total time period of one cycle. 1 by 0.3. Integral of 0 to on period. Why I am taking only 0 to on? Why I am taking the limit 0 to 0.1? Why not from 0.1 to 0.3? Why not from 0.2 to 0.3? Is there any voltage from 0.1 to 0.3? It is 0. During off period, we are not getting any voltage. That's why I am taking the limits from 0 to on period.
Instantaneous value. IV is the instantaneous value. See, instantaneous value is equal to
peak value. Instantaneous value is peak value. See here, at 0, the value is 20. At 0.01, the value is 20. At 0.05, the value is 20. Take at any point from 0 to 0.1, the value is peak value, 20 volts.
Your instantaneous value is 20 volts.
Your peak value is 20. Maximum value is 20. That is your instantaneous value.
Instantaneous value power 1. Here I am taking the power 1. Instantaneous value is 20.
And x-axis t is given. That's why I am taking dt. And x-axis t is given. This is the average value. Now simplify this.
1 by 0.3. 20 you take outside the integral. What is integral of dt?
Tell me the value. Integral of dt is t. 20 by 3. That is 20 by 3. This is the average value. Any doubt in this? In the problem, he is asking average only. Now we'll see RMS also. Is it okay? RMS value. See, average value, I am taking power 1. For RMS value, we are taking squares on both sides. We are taking square on both sides. That is the only difference. Now, instantaneous value is
twenty square is 400. Integral of t is dt is t. Integral of dt is t.
Substitute the values and tell me the answer. VRMS. VRMS, bring the square to the right hand side. It becomes square root of 133. What is the value of 133 square root? Tell me the value of square root of 133.
11.5.
Okay. See here, RMS value is always greater than average value. How much you got average? 6.66. But you got RMS 11.2 volts. In this way, you will calculate average and RMS value for the square waveform. Sometimes they will give triangle waveform also. For triangle waveform, instantaneous value is different. See your textbook. If you are having doubt, one problem is given on triangular waveform, sawtooth waveform. But generally, they will ask for square only. But sometimes they will ask in triangular waveform also. At that time, instantaneous value will be different. You have to take slope intercept y is equal to mx plus c in triangular form and sawtooth waveform also. Okay, that is, this is the solution for the given problem. See here, this is the given problem. They are asking only average value. They are not asking the RMS value, but still you have calculated the RMS value also. Sometimes they may ask RMS value. What is the other name for RMS value? Effective value. Sometimes they will ask calculate the effective value of square wave. Don't confuse. Effective value means RMS value. Effective value means RMS value. So I am stopping the class here. In the next class, I'll explain 4B and we'll complete the second unit in the next class. I'll take the attendance, wait for some time. Okay, I have taken the attendance, now you can leave.